And welcome to another California guy video with your boy California guy. What's up everybody and welcome to this video. It's entitled Coonology, whatever the fuck you want to talk about it, call it. You know, I think of a title in a minute as I go because I do these videos on the cuff. What's up Black YouTube, what's up everybody? I'm just here to chat about coons. I just got through watching Tariq Nasheed's All Nude. Shout out to Tariq Nasheed of New Generation of Coons. I think that's what I'm going to call this video. New Generation of Coons. Now, yeah, a lot of valid points when it comes to coonism and coons. Now, black society is infiltrated with multiple race traitors. And I mean race traitors to the extent that these Uncle Toms side with white supremacy. Now, let's break it down. Whenever there's an incident with African Americans and racism, white racists use a black puppet to justify the racist actions of the African American person. This is a pattern that's been going on actually for a decade. And I mean recently, the new breed of Uncle Toms. This has been going on for a decade. Because every incident that's happened, the black person was to blame. Case in point, and I'm not trying to rehash this, was Trayvon Martin. The Trayvon Martin case, he was killed by a vigilante person that was the police officer for no reason. He was stalked, followed, and killed. But what ended up happening was white people flipped the narrative and blamed his background and his socio-economical upbringing on why he was killed. And you have black people, Uncle Tom's co-signed it. They co-signed why Trayvon was bad. They said they didn't see nothing wrong with it. They was patrolling his neighborhood, everything else. And this pattern has persisted time and time and time again. These black self-haters that's been out here on the loose, even on television such as Fox News with Stacey Dash. She's a new breed of white supremacy at its core. She literally hates black people more than white people. Raven Simone, another race traitor and a race hater. She hates her race. She talks about why we have these names. These people make out like we don't have a culture. The coons have this notion that black people are not supposed to have a culture. They're not supposed to have a culture. They're not supposed to have a name. We're supposed to be just puppets in this society of white supremacy. Now, Jewish people can have their culture. Mexican Americans can have their culture even. But black people, no, you don't. You don't have no culture at all. So that's why a lot of pro-blacks like myself attack the coons, because we're tired of it. The coons never offer up solutions. And I've said this in many of my videos. Where the fuck are the solutions? Why do you motherfuckers do videos, do radio shows, do TV spots, do different TV shows, or write opinionated articles, but yet offer no solutions? You motherfuckers point out that we need to strap up the bootstraps, whatever the fuck you guys be saying, and be a productive American. Well, if that was fucking easy, we all would be rich bastards in this country. Rich black bastards in this country. You got black men who is unable to get work in this country due to white supremacy. That's what the fuck is going on. And you motherfucker coons don't understand why a black can't make it, because you had to kiss so much white ass. Whether you were coons or bed wenches, you've kissed so much white ass that you don't understand why you're in the position you're in today. And it's not due to your own merits. It's due to you selling out. And many blacks like myself do not want to be under white apartheid. We want to escape the plantation, not be a part of the plantation. That's why Tariq Nasheed did the video on the new generation of coons. And you motherfuckers are the new generation of coons. Because all excuses I hear, and there's nothing wrong with being friends with anybody white. I'm not saying that. You can be friends with whatever color you want to be friends with, but the selling out part and not recognizing that racism exists bothers the fuck out of people like myself, who is for equality. Don't you motherfuckers want to have the same equal rights as your white counterpart or your white friends? Why would you accept less than more? That's the problem with coons. And see, pro-blacks like myself, we are the true fighters. I consider myself a failed nigga. You guys are the house niggas. You want the easy way out. While us failed niggas, we are fighting for more freedom. We don't care about master scraps. We'll be in that field. I bet a lot of you men, you black men and black women, if in modern day 2016, if I asked you, what would you be? A coon? I mean, not coon. Would you be a house nigga or a field nigga? A lot of you guys would say you would want to be a house nigga. I really do think you would love being in the house. You would dance and do jigs for a plate of food from your master. And that's not what a lot of us blacks want to do. We don't want to do a jig and scream just for some food. And that's what slaves used to do, house niggas. And you house negroes. Who Malcolm X spoke against over 50 years ago, he spoke against you type of black individuals who do not like your own race, who throw your race under the bus, who don't care about black kids eating, who don't care about black women working two jobs, who don't care about black men out of work and being incarcerated, who don't care about racism at the workplace. That's the shit that I care about as a black man, and you motherfuckers do not care about nothing that's going on in our communities. And I'm telling you, coons, I'm issuing you a challenge. Go into the white community. Go to the white community because that's where you're needed at. You're needed there. We don't need you motherfuckers. Why do you look at black stuff? Why do you care about what pro-blacks say? Because I noticed one thing about you motherfuckers. You guys keep saying that, oh, well, you know, the pro-blacks this, the pro-blacks that. But check this out. You motherfuckers tease just regular black society. Okay, if you want to make fun of the pro-blacks, do that. But when it comes to black shit, you motherfuckers don't talk about it. Coons, let me ask you a question. You talk about pro-blacks and how they don't care about their race. But how many videos have you guys done, radio shows, opinionated ads, or anything else? How many things have you done promoting black culture, black heritage, black art? And I ain't talking about no fucking hip-hop, but I'm talking about like black artists, black literature, black entrepreneurship. How many of you guys done it? Because I've done it. See, if we're going to play this game about being pro-black, we're going to go full circle. You motherfuckers just concentrate on one thing only, and that's, oh, well, you're pro-black and you're a fake revolutionary. I'm not a fake fucking revolutionary. I'm the real deal. I promote black unity, and I promote the rise of black entrepreneurship in the United States and across the globe. I promote the people of Africa. While you motherfuckers sit on your asses and criticize the pro-blacks while we're out doing something. Half of the pro-blacks that you guys hate do shit. So I want you guys to like and share this video. Peace out.